Hi children, now this problem is from exercise 2.4. Okay, actually I did those two sums from previous exercise because many students asked or doubts in that problem. Okay, now let us discuss about this exercise. Here we are going to deal with equations where we have variables on both the sides. Okay, the question is, Hassan buys two kinds of cloth materials for school uniforms. Shirt materials that cost rupees 50 per meter and trouser material that cost him rupees 90 per meter. For every 2 meters of trouser material, he buys 3 meters of shirt material. He sells the materials at 12% and 10% profit. His total sale is 36,600. How much trouser material did he buy? If you just read the question, you may feel something is there, couldn't follow anything. So let us put in crisp. Okay, this is first point from this to this. Here they have mentioned the cost price per meter for two materials. This is first part. In the second part, for every 2 meters of trouser material, he buys 3 meters of shirt material. What does it mean? Can you relate it to something which you already know? For every 2 meters, he buys 3 meters. For every 2, he buys 3. Are you able to link over to some concepts? Yes, children. A few of you would have found out it is nothing but 2:3. He buys material in the ratio 2:3. This is 2 for trouser and this 3 for shirts. Instead of directly giving this ratio, they have given us in word format. You should know to simplify this 2 sentence a single statement 2:3. Okay, now immediately you will say how much material, trouser material is required? 2x meter. How many shirt material is required? 3x meter. Will you all agree now? Okay. Now, the next third part is, his total sale is 36,600. No one will sell without profit, isn't it? So, his profit percentage is given. We know cost price, we know profit percentage, and we have to find the selling price and we have to see it is equal to 36,600. And how much trouser material did he buy? How much trouser material we have to find? This 2x I have to find. This just 2x. To find this 2x, they have given such a very big paragraph. Hope you are following me. The ultimate objective of this problem is to find the value of 2x. Okay, how much trouser material did he buy? Now, I have written whatever I have said now in statements. Ratio of shirt material bought to the trouser shirt material is 3:2. And therefore, shirt material is 3x and trouser material is 2x. Okay? And they have given us the cost price. This much material shirt he has bought. And 1 meter is equal to how much rupees? And what is the trouser cost material? 100 rupees. So, they have multiplied the cost material of the shirt and trouser material. This is 50 and 90 rupees as it is given in the question. So, what is the amount cost price now? This is 2 or cost price. This and this 150 and 180 or cost price for shirt as well as trouser. This is shirt cost price and this is trousers cost price. Now, I know selling price only. Isn't it? Total amount is 336,600. That is selling price. How to find selling price now? We have to find profit and then add it. See here, selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. We know cost price of shirt is 150. This is cost price. And they have given that percentage, profit percentage. Isn't it? CP into profit percentage by 100. This is the profit. 150 for 100 rupees. 12 rupees is profit. Therefore, for 150 into x rupees, this is rupees. For this rupees, how much profit? So I multiply here addition, here multiplication. Hope you understood. This is cost price, and this fully is called as the profit for shirt. Is it clear? This is fully profit. Now, if I simplify, no, I will cancel this 0, 0, 3 5 are 15, 2 5 are 10, 1 2 is 2, 6 2 are 12. So, if I multiply 6 into 3, I get 18x. So, 150 plus 18x is 168x. What is this? This is the selling price. This is selling price. Now, similarly, I have to find for trouser also. What is the cost price for trouser? Just now in previous slide, we saw, see here, this is the cost price of trouser, 180x. Isn't it? Along with this, I have to add the profit. What is the profit percentage they have given? Here, the profit percentage or 10%. See, this is shirts profit percentage and this is trousers profit percentage. Okay. So, I have this to be cost price and profit percentage is 10 by 100. For 180x, we have 180x into 10 by 100. Be careful with the symbols, my dear children. This fully is profit and this is cost price. If I add these two, I get one. Again, you have to cancel this. 1 0 is 0. Next here, 9 2s are 18. So otherwise you can cancel this 10 and 10. Very simple, no? And we will have this 18 as it is. 18, I didn't cancel 18. We have 10 and 10 cancel. So we have 18x. Okay, 180x plus 18x is 198x. Now, we found selling price for both shirt material as well as trouser material. And we know the total sale he had. It is 36,600. So, I have 168x plus 198x is equal to 36,600. This is the required equation. After this, you will all do it. I know that. Come on, start doing it. Simplify it. Be quick. I will count. Shall I count? Okay, you can pass it and find the answer and check whether you have done it right or wrong. Okay, I have to add these two. I get 366x, which is equal to 36,600. Then this will get transposed here in division. And if I divide, I get 100. This 100 is the common factor x that I have to multiply with 2 to get the material required. When I was explaining the question, I told the objective of this problem is to find 2x. That is the length of material required for trousers. So, length of trouser material bought is 2 into x. What is the value of x now? 100. So, he bought 200 meter. Is it clear, my dear children? Shall we move to the next question? These problems are, once you get the equation, the solution part is very simple. Within 2 lines, 3 lines, you will get it. But still you get that equation. Be clear, read point by point, try to classify them, segregate them and get a clear idea about the problem. Okay, children, now the next problem for you is half of a herd of deer are grazing in the field. Grazing. And 3/4 of the remaining are playing. The rest 9 are drinking water from the pond. Find the number of deer in the herd. We don't know how many deer are there. So, I will have it as x. That is what I have to find. Okay. Fix the objective for the problem. Then it will be easy for you to simplify it. I have to find the number of deer in the herd. So, totally let there be x deer. And few of them, that is half of the x deers are grazing. Then remaining there will be how many deers? Another half will be there, no? Half will be grazing and remaining half will be there. In that half, in that second half, 3/4, see here, 3/4 are playing. 3/4 are playing. Then what is the few other rest are doing? Rest nayan are there. Nayan deers are there. They are drinking water. So see here, it's very simple. Let the number of deers be x. Number of deers grazing is x by 2. That is half of the half of the deers. The remaining deers is how much? X minus x by 2, which is nothing but x by 2. This is first half. This is second half of deers. In the second half of the deers, 3/4. 3 by 4 of x by 2. 3/4 of this for this x by 2, I am finding the 3/4. Those many deers are playing. Okay, so we get 3x by 4 to 8. Okay, now how many deers are drinking water? Yes, there are 9 deers drinking water. So, grazing, how many deers are grazing? X by 2. How many deers are playing? 3x by 8. How many deers are drinking water? 9. Totally, how many deers are there? How many deers are there? See the first line. Yes, there are x number of deers. Hope you will be able to frame the equation now. If I add these three types of deers, now these three number of deers, I will get the total number of deers to be x. See here, we got the equation as x by 2 plus 3x by 8 plus 9 is equal to x. Don't you feel the beauty of max? Here also we have x. Here x. Again it is equal to x. That's the beauty, children. You should know to enjoy the beauty of max. Okay. See here. Now as usual, what is the thing we will do? We will find LCM for these three things. Isn't it? Only then we can club all the numerators together. So this 8 is a multiple of 2. So the LCM is going to be 8. What should be multiplied by 2 to get 8? Yes, 4. So I am going to multiply this x with 4. So I will get 4x. Here already it is 8. So if I multiply by 1, I will get 8. So I will multiply this 3x also along with 1. Here I should multiply by 8 to get the LCM. 8. So here also I multiply by 8. So the LCM is 8. And if I multiply this 4, I get 4x. Then 3x as it is. Then 9/8 are 72 here. Divided by LCM 8. The LCM is 8. So I wrote the denominator as 8, which is equal to x. Now what will we do? 4x plus 3x is equal to 7x. Where is the cursor? Excuse me, children. Okay. 4x plus 3x is 7x plus 72. And 8 is transposed to that side. That's why we got 8x. Again, I will transpose this 8x now to right hand side. We will get a 7x minus 8x. Again, I will transpose this 72 to right hand side. I get minus 72. Hope you understood how we got minus 72. 7x minus 8x is minus 1x, which is equal to minus 72. Minus minus divide by minus on both sides. We will get, it gets cancelled. So x is equal to 72. So there are 72 deers in that forest. Is it clear, my dear children? That is our objective and we found the answer. Okay, now what should be added to minus 7 by 3 to get 3 by 7? What should be added? We don't know what is that what. So let it be x. Here it is. And added to minus 7 by 3, which is equal to 3 by 7. This is the equation. But many children will make an error now. What should be added? They will not have plus here. Instead, they will put minus 7 by 3 here. And when they transpose it, it will make it as plus. Okay, so be careful in this signs. What should be added? So I have plus sign. Along with this addition, what should I add now? Minus 7 by 3. So plus into minus will be minus here. When it get transposed, it will become plus. You can do that way also. Or how I have done, see here. This plus, I have changed it as minus. This minus 3, 7 by 3 is as it is. You can go this way also. You can multiply these two you will get minus. Then if you transpose, it will become plus. Okay. So